early word emerges about what President Clinton had to say in his grand jury testimony. The day before the president's testimony becomes public, the White House begins bracing for the fallout.
But the great unknown is how the American public will react once the evidence is released.
Also this morning, we'll take a look back. For 7 years, we've brought you news from across the country and around the world, and it has been our pleasure. But as they say, all good things must come to an end. It's Sunday, September 20th, and this is the final edition of NBC Nightside.
Welcome back to this, our final edition of NBC Nightside. Good morning, I'm Chris Clyton.
Good morning, I'm Tom Donovan. Glad you're along. We will devote much of this half hour to past moments from our seven-year history, including updates from some familiar faces. But first, a look at the top story of the morning.
And we begin in the nation's capital, which lately has been the seat of salacious accusations. On Monday, the nation will hear more details from Kinstar's investigation, including the president's taped testimony, part of which is already out in the open. The Associated Press reports that the president said early in his testimony, quote, "When I was alone with Miss Lewinsky on certain occasions in early 1996 and once in early 1997, I engaged in conduct that was wrong. These encounters did not consist of sexual intercourse, but they did involve inappropriate intimate contact." Ultimately, of course, the public will decide the public's fate, but right now, the jury is still out. Here's NBC's Stan Bernard.
The headline says it all, and Americans across the country are debating whether they need or want it. In California, this woman says yes.
It'll show him his true character when they see that he's squirming on the tape.
At the Dallas-Fort Worth Airport, two congressmen heard from constituents.
For 7 months as a nation, we had to listen to this man deny what he's done. So now, when there's a more balanced argument going on, we're hearing it come back and saying we're not being fair to the president.
At a Raleigh, North Carolina bookstore.
I think that, people have a right to know. It's a shame that this has happened, but I really think that, the more information that gets out, the better that the people will be informed.
Some have concerns for the institution of the presidency.
I just think it's not fair to treat a president like that. I think it's a degrading, the president's status,
A variety of polls have found that between 60 and 70% of Americans say they have heard enough. They don't want the tapes released.
In Baltimore, an attorney offered the view that the president should resign to avoid further national trauma, but the tapes should not be released.
I think that they're doing a great disservice to the grand jury process more than anything else, and I think there will be some frightening consequences as far as the process is concerned.
In Philadelphia, at the Women's Promise Keepers, a Christian fundamentalist group.
I believe that that he should just be held accountable for the consequences of his actions, and that's lying.
But in New York, the other side of the coin.
I feel, as a lot of Americans feel, I believe that we elected him to be president, not pope.
The tapes will be released.
From some Nightside alumni, past and present.
But first, let's stroll down a bit of our own Nightside history.
Of all these stories we've covered, perhaps none is as sobering as the moment they imploded the A.P. Murrah Federal Building in Oklahoma City.
It's been an ever-present reminder of the people who lost their lives in the nation's worst terror attack. Well, about 5 minutes from now, it should come down.
Now you can get this AM/FM Mini Boombox Radio free for trying Allstate Motor Club for 3 months for just $4.95. That's less than 6 cents a day for the deluxe road service protection that takes you further. Listen.
My old motor club limited how far I could be towed. Allstate Motor Club tows me where I want, and there are no mileage restrictions.
My choice? The motor club that gives me a choice. Allstate Motor Club will tow me to their service station or mine.
I used to think I didn't need a motor club. My car is under warranty. Until I broke down with my wife's car. With Allstate Motor Club, I'm covered no matter what car I'm driving.
Allstate Motor Club. Call now and get your 3-month trial membership for only $4.95 for the motor club that takes you further. Other motor clubs limit where and how far you can be towed. Allstate Motor Club will tow your car no matter how far it is to any service provider you choose. Or get your own tow and we'll reimburse you. You also get no-cost roadside service to change a tire, add gas, or jumpstart a battery. And just look at all these benefits included at no extra cost. You're covered in any private vehicle you drive, whether or not you own it. Free coverage for your spouse. Many AAAs charge extra. Emergency locksmith service. Personalized trip planning. You can even use your membership card as an arrest bond certificate just in case. Call now and get this AM/FM mini boombox radio free when you join. You have nothing to lose. If you're not completely satisfied, we'll refund every penny you paid. But we think you'll want to keep your membership year after year, just like these satisfied members. You don't have to have Allstate insurance to join, so act now to get Allstate Motor Club's highest level of road service protection. Here's how.
This offer is available to Visa, MasterCard, and Discover cardholders, so have your credit card ready and call 1-800-984-1119. Charge just $4.95 to your credit card, and you'll get the free mini boombox and deluxe membership kit. Call 1-800-984-1119.
After 7 years of bringing you overnight news and sports, the time has come for this program to close.
That's right. It's been a challenge. It has been fun. Nightside goes off the air after this morning show, and starting tomorrow night, NBC will begin its new overnight programming all night.
We want to thank all the NBC stations across the nation who have brought Nightside to you since 1991.
A heartfelt thanks indeed. In the past 7 years, we've grown and changed as a Nightside family. It's been my pleasure to work with several co-anchors, including Kim Hindrum. And that was our first Nightside Christmas special at the Biltmore House in Asheville, North Carolina, back in 1993. Kim anchored Nightside with me for 2 years and then returned to the NBC station in Memphis, WMC.
What I remember most about Nightside, other than the hours, are some of the events I got to cover. The town hall meeting with the president and all those voters from Charlotte who got to ask questions they thought were important. And what hit me most was they were not the questions you generally hear shouted out by reporters. The other truly memorable event was going to South Africa for the first all-race elections. I interviewed Archbishop Desmond Tutu. Here he was, a doctor of divinity, the leader of the Anglican Church in South Africa, a Nobel Prize winner, and he couldn't vote, something we take so for granted. There were thousands standing in line, from the townships to the cities to the bush. It was democracy, and for them, it was the first time. And then there are the viewers of Nightside, a whole different group of people, from third shift workers to new parents, a lot of folks who work in bars and restaurants, to senior citizens, to other people who just couldn't sleep. When you stopped me on the streets, no matter what city I was in, and said, "Aren't you that woman on TV in the middle of the night?" you made me feel appreciated, and you made it all worth it. Back to you, Tom.
All right, Kim. Great to hear from Kim and to see she's doing so very well in Memphis.
She does indeed look good. You've also worked here behind the anchor desk with another fine lady, Tanya Charles.
Here in the nation's capital, after a very big day of celebration, President Clinton took his second oath of office Monday as the last president of the 20th century.
Tanya, at the second Clinton inauguration, Tanya anchored with me for the past 2 years, but she left Nightside in August, and now she has done something very special that we're all excited about.
Hi there, Nightsiders. Boy, do I miss you guys. I've been gone from the Nightside now for about 6 weeks, and I wish I could say I've gotten more sleep in that time, but there's a very good reason why I haven't, and it's this little guy. If you watched television closely, to the viewers out there, you saw that my frame was expanding. Little Anthony Charles Jr., my husband and I are so happy with his new addition, and boy, I don't get very much sleep at all, so I've been up watching the Nightside and seeing Tom Donovan a lot because I haven't gotten very much rest. Anthony Charles Jr. is only a week old, And so we're just looking forward to him growing and learning, and this is such an exciting time for us. My mom's going to take him for me now. Thank you very much. Well, I was asked to talk about the highlights of working on Nightside, and it was such a fulfilling time with me to be with the show for nearly 3 years. Everything that we've done, all of the Christmas specials, a credit to everyone who has worked with Nightside. Colonial Williamsburg, I think I had to say that about 100 times. That was a very educational and inspirational special. When we went to San Francisco, also for a holiday special, and Denver was just a ton of fun getting skiing lessons from Tom Donovan. I was not very comfortable out there on the slopes, as the viewer saw. Also, the Olympics, and what a challenge that was, given that it turned into a major news event in addition to a sporting event, and everyone pulled together to make sure that the coverage was comprehensive there. I'm so proud of the work that we all did there. The Democratic Convention, and then later on also a special that we did with lawmakers during Black History Month in Washington, D.C. Everything has been such a wonderful learning experience, and I am so grateful to have had the opportunity to be with NBC and also to work with all of you. I think what I'm probably going to remember most, though, is that working in the middle of the night, I think you get to know people a little bit more personally than you would working a 9-to-5 shift. And I will always treasure those relationships, those friendships. We have laughed a lot. We have even cried together. And you all mean so much to me. And that's not going to change. And I know that many of us will keep in touch. And I wish you all individually the very best. I had a wonderful time with Nightside. And, hey, we'll always have the memories. I love you.
What she says is very true. There is a special bond working third shift, third as we shift. Call it. You have to stick together.
The graveyard shift, indeed. She looks wonderful.
She does.
Terrific anchor and a terrific mother.
Yeah, just want to say, hug that baby for us and say hi to your mom and Tony, Tanya. We miss you.
Now, you've done this quite a bit yourself. How many years?
Right. Actually, I began anchoring on the Nightside in 1992, which makes it about 6 years, something like 1,500 nights, give or take a few.
And during that time, give or take a few, during that time, you've covered some big news stories.
That's true. I found a few of my favorites, too, starting with the historic visit of Pope John Paul II to Denver, World Youth Day, 1993.
They arrive by the busload from 71 countries.
And there's a map on the
They anxiously line up and sign up for temporary housing. At times, their excitement bubbles to the surface.
Ask the young people who have made the pilgrimage here to World Youth Day why they're here, and many of them will tell you quite simply they're here to see the Pope.
Under a canopy of clouds, Pope John Paul II brought a clear message on abortion to President Clinton and to America.
Tonight, live from Charlotte, North Carolina, at the NBC News Channel, people are assembled to ask questions about these and other topics as we spend an evening with the President.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
With recent news reports about the First Lady's cattle futures earnings, and with all the whitewater allegations, many of us Americans are having a hard time with your credibility.
No one has accused me of abuse of power in this job, and no one will either. You will not be ashamed of what I do as president. And I tell you, what we need is a little perspective here. I said, okay, let's have this special counsel, and I will shovel them all the information I have. I'll answer all the questions they want to know. But I need to go about being president, worrying about the problems of the American people in 1994.
This is where it all happened 25 years ago, Yasgur's Farm. This area is called the Bowl, and the stage where the who's who of rock and roll at that time performed was at the foot of this hill. This site has become a mecca, not only for those who attended the original Woodstock, but for those who wish they had. Every year, groups of various sizes come here in the summer to play guitars and sing, share their thoughts, and reflect on those 3 days when more than 500,000 people blanketed this hillside.
Hey, look at y'all, tell me what's that you see? Marching to the field of Birmingham. Looks like handsome Johnny with his hand rolled.
Good morning. I'm Tom Donovan in San Diego, and welcome to NBC Nightside.
And good morning to you. I'm Tanya Strong in our home base Charlotte studio. The big news once again this morning comes from the political arena. So let's start with Tom.
All right, Tanya. Well, ready, aim, fire, and fire again. The Republican attack on Bill Clinton was relentless here Tuesday night. Family values, honesty, and economics. The bombs exploded one right after another on the stage behind me.
And you can get a picture. Look at the camera.
I don't know about all this. Just about 7 years ago, wild sea lions began hanging out here on the docks at Pier 39. As you can see, we're very close to them right now, and you sure can hear them barking up a storm out there.
You look like you were conducting those sea lions. What were you doing?
That was part of the Christmas special in San Francisco. And we did pieces on Christmas, and we also did features about the flavor of the city and so forth. And that was a good one. They stopped there on their way to and from the cold waters and their migration pattern.
Well, some great stories here.
Like that.
Yeah, I got it. Another major Nightside story has been our coverage of Hurricane Andrew in 1992. Here are Nightside's Sarah James and Bruce Hall.
Bruce, we can see that you're in incredible difficulties there talking to us, and we appreciate you doing this, but I want you, if you can, to explain for our viewers what it's like to be in the middle of winds like this.
Well, I hate to admit this, but this is my 36th hurricane, so I've been through a number of them. This is one of the four worst that I probably have been through. It's hard because in order to stand here, I've got a gentleman holding me. We have a person holding the cameraman, and we're leaning up against the building. That is the only way that you can do it. You cannot get out and walk through an open area, or else you'll be blown away.
At the time of that report, we knew that the conditions were bad and the storm was very strong in South Florida. We didn't know how bad. It was only after daylight that we saw the tremendous destruction that took place further to the south of Miami and in Homestead area. And of all the hurricanes that I have covered, Hurricane Andrew turned out to be the most destructive hurricane I have ever seen in my career. Hurricane Andrew's story was part of the evolution of Nightside, because this was the first time that we'd actually sent out our own reporters to cover a story. And this set the pattern for the future, when Nightside would try to be at all major events around the world.
The legendary Bruce Hall. Thanks.
The sports special next.
Now those fantastic restaurant onion creations can be made right in your own home. Introducing the Great American Steakhouse Onion Machine. It's easy, it's fun, and it's oh so onion delicious. Don't confuse the Steakhouse Onion Machine with those hard-to-use plastic gadgets that only do small onions. You start with a nice large onion, trim and clean, then remove the center. Place the onion under the stainless steel blades of your Steakhouse Onion Machine and push down. You'll have a perfect onion creation. Just dip it and cook it in oil or bake it in the oven. In no time, your onion is golden brown delicious, just like they serve it in the restaurant. It's a special treat for the kids and great for your own parties. Call now and get this deep frying basket and colorful recipe book. It's only $19.99. So order your Great American Steakhouse Onion Machine now.
To order the onion machine for only $19.99 plus shipping, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-861-1551. Sorry, no CODs.
When I have arthritis pain, I want relief fast. I can't wait. When I rub in Asper Cream, it brings fast relief for minor arthritis pain. The relief lasts for hours, and it's odor-free.
Asper Cream, pain relief without aspirin.
The job, the worries. I need a good night's sleep. I'd use a PM medication, but pain isn't my problem. Stress is. For a good night's sleep, now I take Sleepinol.
When a stressful day keeps you awake, take Sleepinol and sleep well tonight. Feel great tomorrow.
When I have arthritis pain, I want relief fast. I can't wait. When I rub in Asper Cream, it brings fast relief for minor arthritis pain. The relief lasts for hours, and it's odor-free.
Asper Cream, pain relief without aspirin.
The job, the worries. I need a good night's sleep. I'd use a PM medication, but pain isn't my problem. Stress is. For a good night's sleep, now I take Sleepinol.
When a stressful day keeps you awake, take Sleepinol and sleep well tonight. Feel great tomorrow.
A of the memories that open stirs
that
there.
That brings back some, sure.
Kurt Gregory joins us now with sports. He is batting cleanup on this final morning of Nightside, and we're going to take you back in time over the past 7 years in sports.
A wild and wacky and, I would add, wonderful ride it has been, gentlemen. Let's get right to it. 2,510 shows spanning almost 7 years. That's thousands of games, hundreds of interviews, and plenty of special memories. My colleague Mark Barger and I have had the privilege of covering the biggest events from the sports world since Nightside started back in November of 1991. Here now are some of my favorite moments. We'll turn the clocks back to 1993 as the Toronto Blue Jays were closing in on a second World Series title against one of the most colorful teams in baseball history, the 93 Philadelphia Phillies. One game down and two to go for the Philadelphia Phillies as their postseason odyssey continues here in Toronto. One more loss ends the season for Philadelphia. So, in effect, the Phils are playing what amounts to two more games of sudden death.
I guess if you're going to die, it might as well be sudden.
I know it's cliche, but in this case it does fit. The third time being the charm for the Atlanta Braves.
The Braves and their fans had been here before, 91 and 92. Finally, the third time, indeed the charm, Mark. And let's take you inside the Atlanta locker room. The scene, utter jubilation.
The Atlanta Braves are the world champs.
Back to Atlanta. It lasted just 17 days, but the memories of the centennial Olympic Games will last a lifetime.
Now, Kurt Gregory was up close and personal with many of the events, so you can tell us, what's one of the lasting memories for you?
Well, I think first and foremost, the memory that I'll remember forever is little Carrie Strug winning the Hearts of America on the last two vaults.
Okay, real quick, give us the pick.
I'm not brave enough to pick the Broncos. Packers, 23. Broncos 17.
Okay, thanks a lot. Kurt Gregory coming to us this morning from San Diego. And Hillary, sentimentalist, I'll say the Broncos 27-23.
Almost offside, but the Packers got back on. Elway, scrambling, looking, running, diving inside the 5-yard line for a first down. Is he only 37?
If this was Michael Jordan's farewell game, then he gave us a performance to remember. Let's take you down the stretch.
Jordan, open. Chicago with the lead. Timeout, Utah.
That's when Mark McGwire established himself as baseball's new single-season home run king. Here's what the magical moment sounded like on KMOX radio in St. Louis. Mike Shannon, a former teammate and best friend of Maris, has the call.
They are very deep. They play in the full. Back to winds and fires. Big Mac.
I guess in short, folks, it's been one heck of a ride, and I would personally like to thank each and everybody I've worked with down through the years here at Nightside. It's impossible to do that, but thank you all, Chris, Tom, Mark, everybody. It's been great.
Been a lot of highlights that you have brought us, and it's been a highlight for me personally working with you.
I appreciate that, Tom.
All righty.
Chris.
Thanks, Tom. Tom, how about Kurt?
You got it, Chris.
Appreciate it. Yes, sir, very much.
A little flustered.
Nice way to end that piece, too, with another home run. Nightside celebrated Christmas by the Bay in San Francisco in 1996. Our visit included a hot air balloon ride over beautiful Napa Valley. Let's head back to the skies now as we check local forecast for cities coast to coast.
Feel the power of songs for life.
the ultimate new collection of contemporary Christian hits featuring all your favorite artists. Your praise to the Lord. Amy Grant. Stephen Curtis Chapman. For the sake of the call, I'm looking for a reason. Michael W. Smith. Coming through the night to find my place in this world. Thank you. Ray Bolz. Songs for Life on two CDs or two cassettes for just $12.99. Then audition other Songs for Life albums. There's no minimum to buy. Cancel anytime. Feel the power of the best in contemporary Christian music. Get Songs for Life today. Call now.
To order Songs for Life, use your credit card and call 1-800-905-6565. That's 1-800-905-6565. Or send $12.99 for two cassettes or two CDs, plus $3.95 shipping and handling to Songs for Life, Department 1, Richmond, Virginia. Or call 1-800-905-6565.
Time now to bring this last edition of NBC Nightside to a close.
It is indeed, Chris. It's been our honor to have been part of your night all these years. And now a special salute to the men and women who work here behind the scenes to prepare this broadcast. Thanks, and farewell.